water is life. Water is actually needed not only for our drinking, but for all the food we eat, for our industry, and importantly for the ecosystems around us. As we were working in Malawi, we found hundreds of boreholes that were drilled that were just letting water go, just having it going out into the ground. And these artesian boreholes needed to be captured. This water food nexus, this connection between water and agriculture, could be solved with these artesian boreholes. And what we wanted to do is actually find a way to help those that are out there managing these resources find that water food nexus.
In April 2016, a borehole was drilled in Chikabado village in the eastern part of Chikwawa district. When the drilling reached 17 meters underground, pressurized water was struck. This pressurized water started flowing from the borehole at over 5 liters per second. This particular artesian borehole was left uncapped when it was installed, and water was allowed to flow out uncontrolled through drainage channels into nearby streams for over 6 months. This amounts to over 70,000 cubic meters of water which was lost from underground storage during this time. While local farmers managed to make use of this flow by digging a network of irrigation channels to water their crops, only a fraction of this water was being used, and most continued to flow away and was wasted before it was used. When this news reached Professor Kalin and his team at the University of Strathclyde, they decided to carry out work on the borehole to prevent this uncontrolled loss of water and ensure this water resource could be properly controlled and sustainably managed for the future. This was also a perfect opportunity to invite water technicians, engineers, and drillers from across the country to observe the works and learn the skills and techniques required so that they could also perform the same techniques on some estimated 250 uncontrolled artesian wells scattered across the country.
Fundamentally, we're going to go down, take out the existing borehole infrastructure, put in place a packer which will seal up this borehole. And with that, we're able to then put a valve at the top and use the pressure inside of the borehole to deliver water to local communities and local irrigation projects.
While the team had a plan of how to refit the borehole and control the pressure, they had little in way of accurate records giving them detail of how the well was drilled and the method in which the casing and the packing material was installed. It was necessary to bring a drill rig and compressor back to the site to complete the works. With the ground leveled and the drill rig set up, a first attempt was made to remove the 100mm PVC casing with the use of compressed air to loosen the packing material around the casing. This proved unsuccessful. However, the team had a backup plan. On the second day, the team ran a series of pressure tests using an inflatable packer, which proved that the casing and the packing material already installed in the borehole had formed a sufficient seal that was able to hold a sufficient amount of pressure. Following an overnight pressure test, the team was satisfied that with the use of an inflatable packer, the artesian pressure could be controlled, and went to work installing the borehole with the necessary seals, pipework, and valves. Today, the borehole is properly under control and the flow can even be fully switched off, stopping the uncontrolled waste of water. It will now be possible to use this water as and when it is needed as part of a piped network. This will allow the irrigation network at Chikabado to be expanded to include an additional 30,000 square meters of land to be irrigated, and even will be able to direct water uphill or utilizing the natural pressure within the system. More importantly, vital skills have been passed on to water industry professionals within Malawi who can utilize these techniques to properly control other artesian boreholes, preventing more uncontrolled waste of water and ensuring that underground water resources can be controlled and managed sustainably.
I'd like to take the opportunity to thank a few people. First of all, the Scottish Government for the funding under the Climate Justice Fund Water Futures Program, and the government of Malawi for the continued engagement on working together with us strategically for the water resource management of the country. I'd like to in particular thank Drill Corp, not only the time and effort that's been put in by David Gowans, but also the support behind the scenes in helping to train new individuals on what these technologies can do. And importantly, partners like Water for People, Base Flow Malawi, students at the University of Malawi, students at Strathclyde University, and the staff that actually work here. With all of us working together, we're trying to come up with sustainable water resources and to try to actually meet that water food nexus across Malawi.
Thank you.